Hey everyone, it's John Hansen for WGN Radio's Your Hometown. I know you've all seen this water tower, but we are stopping in Rosemont today for Your Hometown, and we're gonna have a lot of fun. We're gonna eat well, we're gonna drink, we're gonna do some shopping and have some fun along the way too. Let's get started.
First things first, we went to the Fashion Outlet Mall. It's just off the tri-state at Balmoral, and there's so many places to check out. I stopped at Levi's for a few pairs of jeans. Didn't fit in the skinny ones anymore. That's okay. Zwillings is this really cool spot. They had knives and a bunch of kitchenware. It's a German company, but right there at the mall, and it has so many cool things. I got to try out some knives, actually. Really cut up a good pepper. I need some at home for sure. And finally, there was this cool spot by the food court called Tapville Social, which you get to like get a card and you get as many different pours. You can try little ones or big pours of different beers or sangria. I got a sangria I took around all over the mall. And one final cool thing about the mall, there was just a lot of local artists that had murals and sculptures. It's just a really great place to walk around and obviously do some shopping and some socializing. I wish we could spend more time there. I'll definitely come back. We visited Parkway Bank Sports Complex and met with former Fast Pitch softball player Sherry Kemp, who talked about an amazing organization she's a part of.
So Athletes Unlimited is a multi-sport professional platform. Right now we have three sports in the women's pro sports space. We launched with softball last August right here in Rosemont. We followed that up with volleyball in Dallas in January, February, March. And then we just are finishing up our first season of lacrosse in Maryland.
For folks that were watching the Olympics, you're going to see some familiar names and faces.
For sure, for sure. We have over 20 players here on four separate teams. So in softball, there were just six teams in the Olympics.
Right.
We have members of four of those teams here, over 20 individual players.
What are the dates? When does it all take place?
We kick it off August 28th, and it goes 5 weeks straight, right through September 27th.
You get to see all the games, some of the games. You can just come for one night and check it out.
Well, here's what I would say about Rosemont is that this stadium is beautiful. It's a great place to take in a softball game. And so you're absolutely going to see people here every
yes.
night, every day, every time we roll it out. And the athletes will embrace that. They love the fans. This is our first season with fans, so this will be a special environment.
Next up, just made a short walk over to Impact Field, home of the Chicago Dogs. The field is awesome. It's right off the tri-state, too. It's great for plane watching. And I got a visit from Ketchup and Squeeze, not only a great place to catch a game, but at the time of our visit, they were just starting to set up some of the holiday decorations for a Maze Light Festival coming up this holiday season, which will be super cool. And it'll be a great reason to visit in the winter, too, to see all the lights and stuff at the ballpark. Now, being at the ballpark made me want a beer on what was a pretty hot summer afternoon. So we went over to King's Dining and Entertainment. This place is huge, especially their bar area, which features several massive TVs. A lot of fun games, too. The Bears, of course, playing. Got to watch them there. The Blackhawks, great spot to watch them. Speaking of the Blackhawks, they had this arcade game. You know, the old hockey one, bubble hockey. I was the Blackhawks as well. And they have some other games, too. I love bowling, though, and I got to play a really quick game. Really is quick when you're just by yourself playing. And I've been trying the spin ball a little bit more, and I did pretty good, all things considered. I think I ended up with like a 120. Anyway, King's is worth the visit. It's in the same area as Zany's in the Parkway Bank Park Entertainment District. After bowling, I was really hungry, and trust me, there's no better place for a nice, filling meal than Carlucci's Italian Restaurant.
35 years here.
Yes.
Tell us about the place.
This place was first opened by the Carlucci family, which is the original, they're from Naples, South Italy. I had an opportunity to come in this place, and I took it different than being in a fancy hotel, but that's my passion.
Yeah.
I love it, and it's on my heart. And, you know, my wife always tell me, I never see anybody go to work as happy.
Yeah.
Because I love what I do.
Tell us about some of your favorite dishes.
Let's start with the appetizers. We have our fried calamari, mm-hmm. are to die for. They have a little kick. They've been on the menu for 35 years, and people love it. On the pasta, I gotta mention our linguine parmesan.
Okay, okay.
It's original as well, 35 years on the menu. It come out on depending on the size of the table, a quarter of Grana Padano. We didn't use the Reggiano because it's too expensive.
Okay.
So the Grana Padano is as good.
Right.
And then they cook the linguine with the butter. We put prosciutto on the bottom of the plate. And then we mix it at table side.
That's nice.
With the peas on the bottom of the plate. And just put on a very, a little bit cheesy, but extremely, extremely good.
Dessert?
Tiramisu.
Yeah.
Everybody make tiramisu.
Right.
And our is original recipe from the grandma, and we never change it.
In 30 seconds, if you could encapsulate, why should someone visit Carlucci?
Because we are traditional. We are not a fast food. We are not luxury food. We are family food. But in the same time, we are elegant. And to me, service is very important. If you get good service with the great food, that's insanity. But if you get great food with the bad service, nobody gonna remember you.
So they were awesome to us. They fed the whole team, and I was thinking, oh my gosh, we're gonna have so much food to take home. And then we didn't. We ate everything, and all those promises to bring food home were unkept. But thankfully, we were near the McDonald's on River Road, so we were able to order on the McDonald's app, which was really amazing because any of the food I ordered can be turned into points for free items in the future, including classics like the Big Mac, Quarter Pounder, and of course those famous fries on future visits. So that does it for Rosemont, and as you can see, there was so much to do. Rosemont, it really is the perfect place to visit with your family, catch up with some friends, or enjoy some of the first-class sports facilities. Thanks so much for watching Your Hometown. Hope we get to see yours next. But for now, we're in Rosemont. It's all here.